Hey guys, BudCat7 here. It is Sunday, September 2nd, 2018, and thank you for coming to the Stonewall Research channel on YouTube. Appreciate it very much. Please subscribe, please like, and again, guys, you know, if you're watching the videos, commenting, you like them or whatever, please hit the like because that helps with the search in YouTube. You know, we want to get this truth out here, and the more likes that are on the videos, the more it helps people search for them. So please do that. Okay, well, anyway, my last video was entitled, you know, the Stonewalls, Stone Age Fulfillment Centers. I wanted to show you some LIDAR images in there, but I wasn't able to get a chance to do that. I got cut short on a video, but if you look at some of the LIDAR images, here's an example of one right here, and you can see in here that, you know, they enhance it a little bit here, and you can see that these walls are closed in. Not all of them, some of them are open, so, you know, there's different purposes for some of this stuff. But the ones that are closed in, you could be sure that these are staging areas for resources, food crops, timber, copper, whatever it is. And, you know, in these areas, these things were put because they were allotted for certain purposes. They were going to go to certain people, either for internal distribution to different tribes, different places, or for export to the people who were coming over here who want to take advantage of this. The deals that they made with the people who were living here at that time, like John Jensen says, you know, 7,000-8,000 years ago. So in any case, I just wanted to show you an example of this. Of course, you can look online yourself and see some LIDAR images of New England. Excuse me, there's not many available because LIDAR costs a lot of money, and you got to have a good reason for doing it. You know, either you're doing land surveys or topographical mapping or whatever it might be. But there's not a lot of them. But if you look at them here, you can see these contiguous areas with some areas of stone walls closed in, some places open. You can see almost like, you know, thoroughfares or causeways going into these places, just like it is at Mallory. So I just wanted to make a short video showing these things because there are some LIDAR images available just to show you an example of what these things were like. You know, and you know, that one video, one picture representation I showed there is about ancient archaeology. So there you have it. You have some people attributing to, you know, not the colonists and settlers, but, you know, the walls already being there. So, you know, go online, get your search engine out, you know, look at some images of this, and you can see. And, you know, I saw many, many examples of this in my travels. You know, Barbara DeLong and Patrick Cook, again, in their video, you know, Secrets of the Stones, they tell it, you know, they ask the question, they beg the question, you know, what are the stone walls for? It doesn't make sense. They're runty. You can step right over them. They're closed in. They have no entrances. And again, I'm telling you again that they didn't want anybody in the areas where the walls were closed and didn't have openings. So, you know, it was authorized personnel only, and they didn't want, you know, this distribution system that they had going get all fouled up by people just grabbing whatever they wanted. It was highly, highly organized. The Native American peoples were very intelligent. They set up this very organized, you know, growing and harvesting and, you know, crops and, you know, distribution system for their people. So just, you know, get it out of your head. It's just, you know, they're just savages living in the wilderness, running around with, you know, deer skins flapping around and whatnot. That's not how it was. I'm sorry. You know, you have to dispel all of these, you know, misguided ideas and all the misinformation. You have to reprogram yourself into a, you know, a new, different view of what the past was. We don't really know what it was, but we're trying to figure it out. Again, if you like my videos, please hit like. It helps people find these things because we got to get the truth out there, guys. You know, we can't let them teach our children, you know, lies about the past. You know, they're only half right or a portion right. You know, these people are all caught up in their emotions about it and everything, and patriotism. And, you know, meanwhile, it's a big red, white, and blue lie. Okay, and we can't have that. Okay, we want the truth, you know, that's it. So in any case, guys, I just wanted to show you these LIDAR images here. Like I said, there's a few of them, but it's very expensive to do LIDAR, so there's not a lot of them here. But if you look at the pictures here, you can see many of these stone wall areas are completely closed in. No entryways, no exit ways, you know, and you know, even at Mallory, there's only one way in and one way out. But, you know, if colonists and settlers are building these things, why are not building openings in the wall? So, I mean, you got to ask yourself these questions. It's all part of the big picture. And we're going to continue discussing this in future videos and about, you know, about what the walls are for, who the people were, who built them, who taught the Indians about, you know, how to do this, what was going on back then, you know. I mean, of course, this is all my opinion and speculation and hypothesis of my own, but it's just as good as anybody else's, you know. Guys like John Delano and Robert Thorson and everything, they don't know. They're making it all up themselves, but unfortunately, they suffer from the illogic of emotional appeal. You know, their emotions are involved in it, so they can't think straight about it. Okay, guys, I just wanted to follow my last video up with this because I promised to show you the LIDAR images. You know, again, you can see closed in areas, you know, again, they're runty walls. They didn't want people in these areas. And, you know, if you wanted to go in this area, just walk right over the wall. I could do it. You could do it. Animals could do it. And certainly people who are 8, 9, and 10 feet tall could just walk right over there. To them, it probably looked like little pebbles on the ground, you know. Okay, guys, anyway, Budcats signing out. Thank you very much. Please like the video. Please subscribe if you haven't subscribed, and I'll see you soon. Bye now.